topic which I will be speaking is about Roman domination, but of course I will speak first about some basic things in order to better introduce what I'm trying to speak about. And of course, everything is related to domination. I mean, everything comes from a very known topic. And then I will speak about all these kinds of styles of variation of Roman domination. And to begin with, consider the case of the domination in a standard way. We have, of course, a graph, which is denoted by G in this way, and we consider a set of vertices S, and this is said to be a dominating set if every vertex which is not in the set S is adjacent to at least one vertex of set S. And the domination number, which I think that almost everyone knows, is denoted by gamma of G, is the minimum cardinality of any dominating set. Here we have, for instance, a dominating set. These vertices in red form a dominating set, indeed the black ones also, although it is not the smallest possible, because we can take these only two vertices which are here in red color, and then we have a dominating set of minimum cardinality, which will be in general denoted by gamma g set of this graph. This is a topic which is very well known. There are a lot of results everywhere about many things concerning domination. It is an old topic, it has applications and so on and so on, so I will not enter too much in this topic. But one of the things which is commonly studied concerning domination is that of studying some kind of variations of domination. And one of the most known, probably, and most studied is the total domination. The total domination is just simply variation of domination in which you are dominating not only vertices of the outside of the set, but also vertices which are in the set. I mean, we have a set S, it's a total dominating set if every vertex of the graph is adjacent to one vertex of the set S. I mean, vertices which are outside of S and vertices which are in S. Must have a neighbor in the set S. Of course, this immediately says that we cannot consider graphs having isolated vertices, even that I didn't write it here, but this is necessary to think about that. And the total domination number is denoted in this way, so again, similarly, the minimum cardinality of a total dominating set. And here we have a total dominating set in this case, the vertices in red and even the vertices in black also form a dominating set. And then another variation of domination is the so-called Roman domination number or Roman domination. This is a concept which is coming from the kind of history topic concerning the domination of the empire, of the Roman Empire, in which it was supposed that the emperor created some kind of idea of how to defend the empire by using some kind of legions. And it was in each of the regions, we have put in one legion, zero legions, or two legions. And depending on these situations, it was possible to define what is now called as a Roman domination or Roman dominating functions or Roman domination number. I mean, we have a function f which is going from the set of vertices to the set of numbers 0, 1, and 2. It is called a Roman dominating function of for this graph G. If for every vertex which is having a label equal to 0, I mean the function evaluating of this vertex is equal to 0, then there exists a neighbor, vertex which is in the neighborhood of this vertex V, such that this vertex has label 2 under this function F. I mean, this is the idea of the Roman domination in this empire. Every legion which will have, region which will have 0 legions to defend them, would have at least one neighboring place or point with 2 legions that can protect them. So the Roman domination number is then the minimum weight of all Roman dominating functions, and the weight of the function is defined as the sum of all labels possible that I can give to vertices in this graph under this function for any Raman dominating function, and is denoted this way, gamma r. Of course, every Raman dominating function induces three sets, which are denoted V0, V1, and V2, which are precisely the set of vertices which are labeled with 0, with 1, or with 2. And then I'm writing this because I will be using this notation in some way. Here we have, for instance, a Raman domination number, a Raman dominating function for this graph, in which we have vertices which are labeled with 2 and vertices which are labeled with 1. This is labeled 2, this is labeled 1, this is labeled 2, and the remaining ones are labeled with 0. So you see every 0 is adjacent to at least 1, 2, and this vertex which is having no possibility to be adjacent to anyone, if it's 0, then must have a vertex, a label equal to 1. And now, the idea precisely was to kind of combine all that things, this domination, Roman domination, and total domination. And with that, we came out with a kind of definition for the so-called total Roman domination. The total Roman domination was an article which was published in 2016, and it was incredibly attracting the attention of several people that after this work, there are a lot of works dedicated to study precisely the total Roman domination number. I mean, we have a function which is a total Roman dominating function if for every vertex which is labeled with 0, I mean, every is having value 0 under this function f, then we have a vertex which is in the neighborhood of this vertex v, which is having label 2. This is the condition to be Roman dominating. And then the extra added condition is that all the vertices which are labeled with 1 or with 2 have no isolated vertices. So the set of vertices, the induced subgraph of this by this set of vertices has no isolated vertices. I mean, wherever we will have 1, we have a neighbor at least 2, or so on. And similarly, the total Roman domination number of this graph is the minimum weight among all possible total Roman dominating functions. You see, the difference is not that much, only we are including this kind of total dominating condition for the vertices which are having labeled 1 or 2. Again, we have these three sets, V0, V1, and V2. And we can consider, for instance, a function like this one here. Notice that now, when we are trying to find the function here, vertices which are labeled positive, 1 or 2, they have a neighbor in the same set. I mean, if I have a number 2 here, this number 2, which is in this corner, must have another neighbor, which will be 2 or 1. There are several conditions, there are possibilities. I mean, I can have a 2 here and a 2 here, and then I can give to all these ones 0. And here, then I can put 1 here and 1 here. As you see here, the weight of this total Roman dominating function is equal to 6, 2, 2, 1, 1. Once this concept of total Roman domination was defined, the idea was precisely to compare it or to find several relationships between the total Roman domination and some other related parameters, because as you can imagine, it is related with domination, with total domination, with Roman domination, and even some other style of parameters which are also related with domination. Then the first was considering the total Roman domination with respect to domination. And the idea is that to find this kind of bound, which is saying that the total Roman domination is always bounded by 2 times the domination number and 3 times the domination number, below and above. And when we consider that things, it was precisely our objective to see what when these things are equal. Of course, we can also consider what is happening with this bound how to get these bounds. The proofs are relatively simple, I would say. If we take a dominating set, for instance, to see the upper bound, the dominating set, we take a dominating set, then we need to give to each vertex of this dominating set a label number 2, and extra for each vertex of this dominating set, we look for one vertex which is not in the dominating set, I mean outside, and we put to this vertex a label number 1. Of course, when you sum this, all this is given 3 times the domination number, and it is more or less natural to consider this. Then the conditions are now considering when that situations we have the quality, we get, for instance, that if the total Roman domination number equals 2 times the domination number, then it must happen one of these things. First, the domination number should be equal to the total domination number, or there exists a set of vertices S in this graph G such that one of these conditions happen. The subgraph induced by this set S, which is denoted in this way, G in S brackets, is precisely the union of several complete graphs K2. So at least one. Also, that the domination number of the graph G, when we remove all these vertices of the set S, is precisely equal to the total domination number of the same graph, and also that no neighbor of the of a vertex of this set S, now in the graph G, belongs to the total dominating set of minimum cardinality in this graph G. When we remove the set of vertices S, this, of course, situation is not that exactly clear when we. I would say this kind of result is not given so clearly conditioned, as you see, because it depends on finding again the domination number or the total domination number of a set of vertices which we more or less exactly don't know what is it, but at least we can give some kind of condition which are centered into how to obtain equality for this case. The upper bound was in some way easier to define, but even to study, but even so it is a little not clearly. So if the total domination number, total Roman domination number is equal to the to 3 times the domination number of this graph, then we have that every dominating set of minimum cardinality or gamma G set is precisely a packing. I mean, notice that when I was speaking about bounding, about how to prove this bound, upper bound, I mean, I was taking a dominating set of minimum cardinality, I was giving a label equal to every vertex of this set, and one to one extra vertex of this one neighbor, which is not in this set. I mean, this one means that I will have a 2 plus 1 here, and the remaining vertex will be 0. In the first moment in which we will have vertices which are adjacent in the in a total dominating set of minimum cardinality, then I will immediately get not this equality, will be much less. Also, if it is not a packing, means that 2 vertices in this set, they will have a common neighbor, then I can also take this vertices for this extra one which is outside, and then we'll give again much less than this 3 times domination number. So the only possibility is that every dominating set of minimum cardinality will be a packing in the graph G. So when this situation, these two situations happen, then we have this condition. But of course, we have here no characterization of these situations. So one of the things which we are interested in, and precisely one of the problems that I could like to remark, is precisely that of characterizing when we have equality for the total Roman domination number with 2 times the domination number or 3 times the domination number. So this is an open problem. Another relationship between total Roman domination is clearly with total domination. And then it is not exactly complicated to see that the total Roman domination is bounded by the domination number and two times the domination number. I mean, if you take a total dominating set and we give a number two to every vertex of this set and zero to the remaining ones, then we clearly obtain a total Roman dominating function. And of course, a set of vertices which are labeled with one or two is a total Roman dominating set, so nothing to say. Then, in this case, was easier than the case of domination number, because, for instance, it's possible to see, not that complicated, that the total domination number equal to the total domination number, if and only if the graph G is the disjoint union of copies of the complete graph K2. And also here, for the upper bound, it was not easy to characterize, even it's not. I'm not so clear that it's possible, that the total Roman domination number equals two times the total domination number, and we take S, which is an arbitrary total dominating set of minimum cardinality, then we have this condition, that the kernel private neighborhood of every vertex of this set S with respect to the set S should be different from empty set. So this is the only condition, I think, that we know about this equality, and it would be nice to characterize also this case. Since this case, the total Roman is equal to the total domination is relatively easy, was the first one, then it is also possible to characterize when it is equal to the total domination number plus one. And this is only in the case in which the maximum degree of the graph, it will be precisely equal to the order minus one. Now, in connection to this upper bound, that total Roman domination and two times the total domination, then we define what is called the total Roman graph. I mean, we say that the graph G is a total Roman graph is if the total Roman domination number is equal to two times the total domination number. And this concept is coming from a similar concept for the case of Roman domination concerning the Roman graphs. In the case of the Roman graphs are those ones which are satisfying that the Roman domination number equals two times the domination number. And this is an open problem indeed, which exists nowadays to characterize all Roman graphs. It is known that, for instance, it is a given a constructive characterization of all the trees which are Roman, I mean all the Roman trees, having Roman domination equal to two times the domination number. So, for the case of total Roman graphs, it is clearly that a graph is a total Roman graph if and only if there exists a function which is satisfying that the vertices labeled with one is empty, but this is indeed not useful. So, an open problem is related to characterizing all total Roman graphs. But some particular cases are already known, like total Roman trees are already characterized in the similar way as the total as the Roman trees are already characterized too. These characterizations are indeed constructive. It means that by beginning with a tree, we begin to construct all the possible trees that we can find. But indeed, it's not clear for me that when we have a tree, anyone, if we can really make polynomially or easily to check that this construction is coming from the initial construction, because I don't know, probably you have seen these articles, but many times these constructions are given in the following way. This tree is constructed by using these operations, and many times we have 10, 15 operations, so it's not that exactly clear how to do it. It seems that proving that the graph is a Roman graph is indeed an NP-complete problem, because I have been once speaking with somebody about this, and it was possible to prove that proving that if a Roman graph is indeed a Roman graph, it is NP complete. So this is the reason that I think it is not that easy. And of course, the similar situation should occur for the case of total Roman domination. Then, of course, the total Roman domination is also related with the Roman domination. And the results are as follows. So the total Roman domination is always bounded by the Roman domination and bounded by 2 times the Roman domination minus 1 in this case. Well, proof of that things are, I think, also not that exactly difficult to see how they are related. And the most interesting is when we can have the qualities as in such bounds. So the total Roman domination is equal to 2 times the Roman domination minus 1, only in the case that the graph G is having a maximum degree equal to the order minus 1. But nothing is known about when we have the total Roman domination equal to the Roman domination. I mean, to the best of my knowledge, I don't know, probably there could be some work in which this could be done, but in this moment, I'm not aware about any reason about this case, for trees or for whatever. So this is also an open problem and a thing that can be done and that will be interesting to do. Now, this is in general the main things I wanted to speak about total Roman domination, but indeed there are several other related results that we can find in the literature. For instance, this already studied the computational complexity of the related decision problem. We find also some kind of Nordhaus-Gadow bounds for the total Roman domination number. There are characterization of trees for which the total Roman domination equals 3 times the domination and 2 times the domination. There are some studies on total Roman domination in some product graphs. I have seen, for instance, the Sigma graphic, and I have seen really relatively recently the case of direct product. Probably there are some other ones, but I'm not so clear now. There are some results concerning the influence of edge subdivisions on the total Roman domination number. There are studies on interval graphs, and even I have seen the studies on digraphs. And recently, I have one of the things that have been commonly done is finding some kind of variants of total Roman domination, which are indeed also variation of Roman domination. One of them is the quasi-total Roman domination. How it comes this one? So the Roman domination, it is this already known concept. The total Roman domination is very natural, just in the way in which we try to kind of totally dominate all the vertices which are labeled with 1 or 2. However, when we get to it, when we want to get this total domination property, we can have situations like this one. For instance, we have this graph, and the only possible total Roman dominating functions of minimum cardinality are these ones. Or we put a number 2 here, and then we need to label all these vertices with 1, or we put 1, 2, and all these vertices with 2. Then in some way, this is kind of increasing much the weight of the Roman dominating function in order to achieve this kind of total domination property. So one idea which came out was precisely to, in some way, decrease this, but of course, maintaining the Roman dominating property. And to do this, it was created this function called quasi-total Roman domination. It was an article which was published relatively recently. This is in the following way. We have a function which is going from V to 0, 1, 2. It's called a quasi-total Roman dominating function if every vertex which is labeled with 0 has a neighbor with which is having label 2. And in addition, if there is an isolated vertex in the subgraph induced by the set of vertices labeled with 1 or with 2, then this vertex must have label equal to 1. I mean, in the subgraph induced by the vertices labeled with 1 or 2, I'm allowing induced isolated vertices only when they are labeled with 1. For instance, the quasi-total Roman domination number is the minimum weight of any quasi-total Roman dominating num function. And again, we have these three sets. For instance, if we have this graph, which was below, before, then we need to add only once in all these points, which are in the right side, a 2 here and 1 here. So I need only one extra one adjacent to these two. And this is, of course, decreasing much because if I am here, I am taking 2, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, and then I can remove all these ones which are adjacent to the two except one. So I mean, I can leave only this one or this one or this one or them, or I can have here whatever. So here I have 4, 8, 10 weight, and then when in the new variant, I am removing 3. So this is 4, 5, 7. So it is kind of good condition. I'm getting good, better results if I'm introducing this situation. Of course, this quasi-total Roman domination function, domination number, it is related with all, again, these parameters, Roman domination, domination, total Roman domination, and so on and so on. But the first and most interesting relation is that a quasi-total Roman domination number is between the Roman domination and the total Roman domination. So in some way we are better bounding the total Roman domination number and upper bound, a better bound for the Roman domination number with this quasi-total. So it's kind of something which is appearing in the middle. Although these two bounds are quite easy to get, nothing is known about the graphs for which the Raman domination number is equal to the quasi-total Raman domination number, or the quasi-total Raman domination number equal to the total Raman domination number. One thing is that these equalities can be, of course, achieved. We can have equality here and equality here, and here we have some, for instance, examples. And of course, also can be much different between one and the other. For instance, if we have a function, a Raman dominating function, then we can always say that the quasi-total Raman domination number is always bounded by the Raman domination number plus the cardinality of this V2. So the vertices which are labeled with 2. And if we have a quasi-total Raman dominating function of minimum weight, then the total Raman domination number is always bounded by the quasi-total Raman domination number plus the cardinality of vertices labeled with 1. I mean, I can always do a little kind of bounds, although these are not exactly bounds, because as you see here, I am indeed using a function to bound exactly the function. And of course, there are always equalities for this situation. We can always find a graph G and a function which is satisfying this equality and which is satisfying this also this equality here, these two equalities. One interesting thing is related precisely to this bound, these two bounds. I wanted to remark this one, but I would like to study when these two equalities are satisfied, at least for families of graphs like trees or like, I don't know, chordal graphs or unicyclic graphs or whatever you will want to do. Of course, this total Roman, quasi-total Roman domination number is bounded, is related with some other parameters like the total domination. And it is possible to see that it is bounded by the total domination number and 2 times the total domination number. This in the same style of total Roman domination number, as you see, but it was not possible to get something more, something nicer, I would say, with respect to total domination. But it's indeed, for instance, that it is equal to the total total domination if and only if the graph is by P2. I mean, so it's not much to say. And then the total domination number, total quasi total Roman domination number equals the total domination plus one if and only if the quasi total domination Roman domination is equal to 3, so in this case, and also that the quasi total Roman domination number equals 2 times the total domination if and only if these two equalities happen. So if it is indeed equal to the total Roman domination number and the total Roman domination number equal 2 times. So the domination. So as you see, are just kind of translating one condition to the other one. So this is making not much sense. In this sense, of course, it would be interesting then to know when we have equality, really. So when we get really these equalities, what does mean? Can we get something positive here or not? So, some extra results about this quasi-total domination are, for instance, the NP completeness of the related decision problems. There are, again, some Nordhaus-Gadum results for this parameter, and there are some bounds for the parameter in terms of order, and so on and so on. At this quasi-total Roman domination number, this only one article on the topic, so almost everything that you could think probably will be good contribution to the topic. So everything is welcome. As you see, there is not much, but several things could be done: studies on product graphs, studies on these equalities, and so on and so on. And look how fast I'm going. Okay, half an hour I still have. Then one other variation of this Roman domination or the total Roman domination, it is something that is recently being very popular. I have seen when we are considering some relationship between Roman dominating functions or in general functions, dominating functions with independence in the following way. So the definition of parameters which are called outer independent E, and then together with something, in this case with Roman domination or total Roman domination. We say that a Roman dominating function, again from label it from 0, 1 or 2, is an outer independent Roman dominating function for the graph G if the set of vertices labeled with 0 is an independent set. I mean, I'm just taking a function, but the condition is that all vertices which are outside of vertices labeled with 1 or 2 will be an independent set. In this way, of course, I can relatively easily control what is happening with vertices which are inside. And a total Roman dominating function is the same idea, is an outer independent total Roman dominating function if the set of vertices is independent. The same idea. So outer independent, total or not total. And the corresponding parameters are in denoted in this way: gamma OIER or OITR. Outer independent Roman domination number and outer independent total Roman domination number, which are the minimum weights of these corresponding functions. Of course, again, we have the same sets which are induced by these labelings, which are labelings with 0, 1, or 2. And functions in general are written in this way. Another way of seeing, of speaking about this is considering not a kind of outer independent Roman dominating function, but kind of, I would say, covering total Roman dominating function. Because if we have a vertex, a Roman or total Roman dominating function, which is outer independent, I mean, all the vertices which are outside is form an independent set, then all vertices which are labeled with 1 or 2 will form clearly a vertex cover set. So this could be understood also as a covering total Roman dominating function. I have seen also that some people are calling in this way this kind of functions. So not outer independent Roman, but covering Roman functions. Of course, these outer independent total or without total are related to several parameters, as you can imagine, domination, total domination, and so on. And even we can here relate it with independence number or vertex cover number. This is, of course, giving much possibilities to play in some way with relationships, with bounds, and some kind of characterizations, and so on. The first thing is that, of course, the outer independent Roman domination and outer independent total Roman domination are related. So when we take a graph G and a function which will be an outer independent Roman dominating function, then always the total Roman domination number is bounded in this way. Below the outer independent Roman and above two times the outer independent Roman minus this cardinality of V2, which is vertex is labeled with 2. If I do not consider a function, but I leave it in open for whatever, of course, I can remove this minus here, and I will have that this between outer independent and two times outer independent Roman domination numbers. It is possible to say that the outer independent total Roman domination number equals two times the outer independent Roman minus this cardinality of V2, if and only if the graph G is star with at least two leaves. So this is at least possible to characterize. Another relationship is with independence number. It's in this case denoted by beta. When we take an outer independent total Roman domination number function, then denoted in this way, then always the outer independent total Roman domination number is always at least the order minus this independence number plus cardinality of this V2. So this is in general relatively easy to use, I think. It's not something really complicated. And here appears an extra parameter, which I didn't speak about, is that the outer independent total Roman domination number is between this parameter, which I will explain now what is, plus one, minus, and two times this parameter. This TCOI of G is called the total co-independent domination number. I am using the notation and terminology which already exists, but it could be said the total outer independent domination number. So by the name, I think that you can guess what is it. A total dominating set whose complement is independent is called a total outer independent dominating set. So the total outer independent domination number is precisely the minimum cardinality. Total dominating set whose complement is an independent set. Of course, I need to consider the case when we have a graph which is not having isolated vertices. Otherwise, the total domination property is not satisfied. So with this, it is possible to bind this parameter. Another relationship is between the outer independent total Roman domination number and the vertex cover number. In this case, it was possible to prove that it is bounded by the vertex cover number plus one and three times the vertex cover number. And the characterization, of course, of these bounds are always of interest. And in this case, the upper bound, when it is equal to three times the vertex cover number, is happening only in the case in which the graph G is a star graph with at least two leaves. And here, one interesting situation happened that when we are considering this relationship, since this characterization was relatively easy, it was interesting to consider what happened when we decreased by one. And it was possible to give some kind of interesting characterization. I mean, the outer independent total Roman domination number equals 3 times the vertex cover number minus 1, if and only if the graph is the union, belongs to the union of two families, F1 and F2, which are constructed in this way. This is the kind of characterization I would say that I like, because in this way I am characterizing exactly which are the graphs which are attaining the quality, not that I am giving some kind of construction that many times is not easy to verify. But here no, because here I am seeing how the graph looks like, and is of course not also some kind of trivial characterization like this one. It is only 3 times the vertex cover number when we have a star. So it's not much to consider. But here the construction is relatively not clear, and to deduce this, then it's required a lot of interesting connection results and some kind of ideas which are behind, which are working nicely. So these families are constructed in the following way. The first one, which is in this style of construction, begins with a vertex, which is kind of central vertex. And then from this central vertex, I can do the following things. I can add some kind of cycles C4 in this way. I mean, here I have one cycle C4, I have other one more, and so on. I can add as many vertices I will have here, will want here, all of them adjacent to this one. So I'll have a common vertex. And then here I can add some leaves, as much as you will want. I can add or not, doesn't matter. So here you see again the same. I have a cycle here, C4, and I have added some vertices here. See here again another C4, and so on. And the other possibility is that I will add not a cycle, but path on 3 vertices. So I mean this path here, and at the end of the path, I can add leaves, as many as I will want or not. Here, for instance, another path, and these 2 leaves adjacent to this. This is the way of this of constructing the first family. And the other possibility is constructing in this way. I begin with a cycle of order 6, for instance, this one, and then I mark 3 vertices in this cycle, which will form an independent set. For instance, these 3, which are black vertices here. And then I can do the following. These vertices, I can add leaves as many as I will want. For instance, I can add here 1, I can add 2, here 4, or I could not add any one. And for those vertices which are here in the middle, I would say kind of make copies of these vertices and join with these 2 vertices. For instance, for this, I add this vertex and join with these 2 vertices. Or for this, I can add these 2 vertices and add as many as you will want. Or I can simply leave it like it is here. No, nothing happened. Then these 2 possible families of graphs are the only ones for which the outer independent total Roman domination number equals 3 times the vertex cover number minus 1. It was kind of a nice construction, and this is the idea that this is the reason that I like to remark it, because it is the kind of construction which is giving something positive, I would say. It's not construction which is for after checking if we can really use it or not. Now, for this outer independent total Roman domination number, since it is equal, it's bounded by 2 times this total co-independent domination number, then in the same way of Roman graphs or total Roman graphs, then we think about introducing the total co-independent Roman graphs. I mean, a graph is total co-independent Roman graph if the total outer independent total Roman domination number equals 2 times these parameters. And of course, as I was telling, it comes from this analogous standard Roman domination. When we have this equality, Roman domination equals 2 times domination, and which is indeed an open problem which is still existing. And in this case, it was possible to do the following. We say that the graph G is a total co-independent Roman graph if and only if it has an outer independent total Roman dominating function of minimum cardinality, which has vertices leveled with 1 equal to empty, which is indeed not exactly useful characterization, again, as in the other cases. But then in this case, we get something like that. Such graphs, which are TCI Roman graphs, are satisfying the following situation. For any outer independent total Roman dominating function of minimum cardinality, which is having this empty in the vertices labeling with 1, we will obtain that the set of vertices of the graph can be partitioned into 3 sets, which are L of G, S of G, and SS of G, which are the following. The set L of G is the set of leaves of the graph, I mean all vertices of degree 1. The set S is the set of supper vertices, I mean all vertices which are adjacent to a leaf or a vertex of degree 1. And this SS is the set of semi-support vertices of the graph G. I mean, all vertices which are adjacent to a supervertex vertex, but that are not the leaves. So in this case, the vertices labeled with 0 is precisely the set of leaves and the semi-support vertices. And the vertices labeled with 2 are the support vertices. And if the vertices labeling with 2 is a total co-independent set of cardinality order minus the independence number of the graph. If this one happens, then we have some kind of relationship for these parameters. Again, this condition is not exactly completely special, I would say, but it's more than for the case of Roman domination or total Roman domination, for the Roman graph or total Roman graphs. I mean, this kind of relationships are easy to deal with. It can be checked, probably. So it is a good thing that these results can be obtained. So this is in general all the things that I wanted to speak about, and then I finally just a kind of remark some of the open problems which I was speaking before. For instance, it would be interesting to characterize all the class of Roman graphs, or that are total co-independent Roman graphs. Well, this case of Roman trees are characterized because, as you see, this case, this kind of construction is given much when we have a tree. If we have a tree, it is very easy to know when this one is happening, because we have only leaves, supports, and semi-supports are easy to control in the tree. Or we can study the outer independent or quasi-total Roman domination number of other families of graphs, like trees, Sierpinski graphs, or product graphs, and so on. And particularly, I would like much to study this inequality chain. I mean, when the quasi-total Roman domination number is bounded is equal to the Roman domination number or the total Roman domination number. So, I mean, characterizing these two possible equality, at least for trees or for some other families of graphs, which will be even less simple than trees. And then this is in general what I wanted to speak to you. So thank you very much for staying here and listening to me, and that's it.